morning, afternoon, evening, YouTube, whenever you are watching this. Welcome to week six of the mini cut. Week six hit yesterday, check-in day. I, as you saw, did my first outdoor check-in. Tough day yesterday, just looking and feeling very flat now. Carbs are low, food in general is low, overall energy is low. Yeah, but we are moving forward. As of today, this is my first full body session. So I managed to negotiate last week removing the three lower days. I might have mentioned that in my last video already. But yeah, no more doing three lowers. We've got full body today, which I'm excited for just because it's something a bit different. Having a pump pre-workout for a change. This is just the Innova Farm one. I think it's called Neuro Pump or something. I'm hoping to get somewhat of a pump. I probably won't because I've just had a massive meal, but I went and bought a load of like broccoli and cauliflower. I forgot to have my potatoes as usual, but it's fine because I've had oats, and realistically I meant to have, now that the carbs are pretty low, I've got a 40 gram carb meal pre and post, and yeah, I've had oats pre, so, and then just that extra meal, just with it being like getting on for 1 o'clock now, I've had another meal, just like a protein only meal without the potatoes. And with all that veg, I was absolutely stuffed. So just like, they're so fibrous, like broccoli and stuff, and I'm just so full. So yeah, kind of glad I didn't have the potatoes because I'd be feeling really uncomfortable right now. You'd get the best pumps if you were actually fasted. So excuse me, just turning away from you. I am just putting on a little bit of makeup. I mean, you know, not everyone thinks it's necessary to wear makeup to the gym, but I have sort of found really that I prefer to just show up a little bit, in the sense of just trying to make an effort with myself. It's so easy when you just like, you work for yourself, you work from home, you spend the majority of the time at home, and then you just go to the gym. It's so easy to just like not really make any kind of effort. But I always just feel a little bit better with a teeny bit of makeup on. Just showing up for myself every day, really. And yeah, that is literally it. So I'm just getting ready for now. It generally makes me feel a little bit better when I train, if I just feel like I've presented myself well. I know that sounds really weird, but yeah. Maybe we're just at that stage of the diet. But either way, always use a bit of powder as well, just to block the shine of the foundation. Gals, if you know, you know. But yeah, I'm actually going to take you along to the gym with me today, show you my full body session, and I will give you some updates. We're now kind of 9 days out from actually finishing the worst of this diet, getting the low food days out of the way, and yeah, then I'll be doing a little mini peak. So from next Friday, because Friday the 1st of March is photo shoot day, so next, which is kind of crazy to think, but next Friday will be a week out from March, which is mental, but there we go. So I will check in next Tuesday, and then I'll get my kind of peak protocols that start on Friday. It won't be anything mental, it won't be like a pre-show carb up or anything like that, because obviously I'm not particularly massively lean or anything like that, but I just need to be fuller for the shoot, because I'm very flat right now and it doesn't feel nice, and I would not feel good doing a shoot when I have empty muscles, because, you know, I'm all about showing them off and feeling good. So yes, we'll be doing a mini little peak, a mini carb up, which I'm excited for, and I will obviously vlog that for you all as well next week. But yeah, for now, I feel like I've done enough with my makeup. I always just do a little coat of mascara, so I don't have like a foundation face and like bald eagle eyes. Little coat of mascara on top of my foundation. Hopefully that looks okay, you know? Like I said, just a little bit of something. And then yeah, I can tie all this scruffy hair back. That's the thing when you're dieting as well, like your hair just constantly looks like frizzy and fluffy because you're just sweating on it every morning. And obviously we don't wash our hair every day because that's not good for your hair. So yeah, ready to go and smash my session. Okay, let me run you through the new full body workout. So starts with adductors, as of course this session used to be a lower session,
And we still have 3/4 lower exercises in. I say slash four because we were going to move calf raises at the end, but they're still in. I will get to that point later on down the line. But yeah, adductors to start. So 3 working sets. And yeah, with this, as you can see, I'm quite near the stack. So I really just try and focus when I'm doing this. I've been poor with it in the past on just really controlling the path of movement, really controlling what I'm doing when I'm coming out into the stretch and into the pause as well, not just flinging the weight from A to B, but kind of really controlling the change of direction, essentially. And yeah, just basically making it harder for myself. Honestly, like, these sets are really difficult. Like, my adductors are so pumped by the end of 3 sets, but that's kind of my main driving focus when I am doing these. Apologies for the angle as well. This is a really small space that the actual machine is in, so I had to kind of try my best with filming the sets. But set 2, I think I managed to actually get my face in it. Good for you. Exercise 2, you've absolutely seen this beauty before, leg extensions. This is my second lot of leg extensions of the week. Do them on a Monday, do them on a Wednesday. 3 sets, 10 to 15 on both sessions, basically. And yeah, it's just, I'm slowly but surely actually managing to increment this stack. So more and more weight going on as the weeks go on, which is nice. And yeah, again, just really focusing on the control. So contracting hard at the top and controlling the weight on the way down. But yeah, we're not kind of trying to be too slow and too pausing at the top. We get a solid contraction at the top, a good squeeze, and then we just bring it straight back down again. Smith machine hip thrusts is the third exercise and absolutely worth the faffy setup. It's not really that faffy, but yeah, just making sure that obviously you've got something comfortable for your back to go on, trying to think about the shoulder blades resting on the box ideally. And yeah, as you can see, the range of motion is pretty short. This is almost a bit more like a glute bridge kind of movement, so keeping that range of motion really short, which obviously the Smith machine helps you to do, because as you can sort of see from the setup, like, it's pretty difficult for me to actually really get any lower than I'm going or even push any higher than I'm pushing. So yeah, it keeps the range of motion nice and short, which is how I like to do any variation of hip thrust anyway. Because yeah, it just keeps the glutes really nice and engaged. And you know, a lot of people will find that they're going nice and heavy, which, well, they think it's nice and heavy, but they're actually just engaging their hamstrings and other parts of the lower body musculature. So yeah, this actually means that you keep your glutes engaged throughout and get a really good solid connection. So yeah, 3 exercises, adductors, leg extension, and hip thrusts, all hitting different parts of my lower body. So yeah, I don't feel pretty too smashed actually after these 3 exercises, which is really nice. So we move on to the upper body portion of this session now, and it's the incline Smith, which I was doing anyway. We've pretty much just, there was another leg exercise in this session, which was Smith squats. It had been changed from dumbbell split squats and then moved to Smith squats and then back to dumbbell split squats, because the split squats just messed with my hip, which is why they came out in the first place. But yeah, it's so nice to not have that 4th leg exercise in now, because it wasn't working out for me really. I wasn't recovering, it was hurting my hip, whichever exercise I had in. The Smith squats didn't work out, and now I get to focus on upper body. Absolutely smashed the Smith this time, got 2 reps up on that weight, which is 50 kilos, so I was really, really happy. So yeah, so nice. I do 3 working sets on the incline Smith, so 10 to 15 reps on each of the 3 sets. And this was set 2, which I dropped to 40 kilos. And actually, because this one went so well and I got so many more reps than the previous week, I actually kept this load for set 3 as well. So really happy with that, because previously I'd been having to drop down to 30, which kind of a little bit soul destroying, because I was pressing 60 kilos
prior to this diet, and then I've had to move down to 50 kilos for my top set. So to back off to 40 is fine, but then 30 is like, wow, okay. So because I was previously doing like 60, 55, 50, and then it's really dropped off. The strength on this mini cut, obviously, because it's been pretty aggressive, has dropped off quite a bit. But pushing back up, I got a really fresh kind of burst of motivation this week, and yeah, just generally feeling a lot better since my sort of down day on Tuesday. And yeah, this session was mega, to be fair. Then after the Smith incline press, we go straight into our lateral raise giant set of 40 reps, which is absolutely delightful. And you've got to wait for it, but the random prick next to me, that's a joke, by the way, he used the words, not me, but he, watch him just like think that I'm finished my set and then just like decide to put his dumbbells back right in front of me. So obviously with a giant set, your aim is to kind of just do as many reps as you can to failure, and then take a 20 second rest and then go again. And what you're aiming to do is hit 40 reps. So I've got the 5 kilo dumbbells here. Do as many reps as I can. I think I got about 22 on the first round. And then, you know, you take 20 seconds off and then you go again. Get as many more reps as you can. Top it up. So I think I got maybe 10 on the next. So I was up to like 32 reps. And then I had another rest and I had sort of like 8 reps left to do to get to 40. And once you're at 40, obviously you can stop. And that is the nature of a giant set, bit of an intensifier. But yeah, here I'm like, I'm not finished. I'm ready to go into my next one. And then he just decides to just go and put his dumbbells back on the rack. And I'm like right about to start my next set. So I just had to smile and laugh, and he like apologised afterwards. But it was absolutely fine. We ended up like chatting for most of the rest of the session, to be fair. So after this, I did dumbbell single arm row, and then I did some arm work. So I did bicep curls on the cable and tricep extensions as well. Well, like pushdowns, I should say. And yeah, I didn't film any of that because like we were just talking, and I think I already got him in a lot of the footage here. So he's featured enough on my YouTube. So yes, I let him off and I did not film my arm stuff because yeah, we were like sharing the same cable stack basically. So yeah, just enjoy the rest of delts and then we'll look at the dumbbell single arm row next. Dumbbell single arm rows are in the programme now, which is great. So 3 more sets for my back going in across the week. And yes, with this exercise being new for now anyway, obviously I've done it in the past, I just mean new for right now. I haven't done it in a while. I just wanted to gauge what weight I could do. The first 2 sets are 6 to 10 reps. So I picked up a 40 kilo dumbbell, got 7 reps with okay form. So yeah, I was happy enough with this. Obviously next week I will just be basically going in at 40 kilos again and just making the reps look tidier, look better. And that's, you know, that's the way I'll be progressing it next week pretty much. But yeah, apart from that, felt really good. And yeah, I've missed this movement. I love kind of this type of free weight movement. I do really enjoy just generally like free weight rows for back at the moment, just literally moving heavy weight from A to B, but getting a really good connection, getting a really good pump. So yeah, happy with it. This was set 3, so by this point, pretty much halved the load to 22.5 kilos. So as you can see, the weight moves a lot easier. I'm able to really just control the path of movement, get a really, really good connection as well at the top there. Just, you know, pause a little bit longer than, you know, when the weight was heavier. So it's a nice kind of, it's a nice balance, really. Top heavy set, and then second set, I did 30 kilos, and then dropping down to 22.5. It's like, it's a nice balance of moving heavy weight from A to B, coupled with then like, you know, slow controlled form. And honestly, like by the end of this third set, my back was so pumped. So like 3 sets, literally that's it. But that's added into my week. Back and lats particularly, something that I really need to grow. So then having these extra sets in my week is just making me happy because I didn't need really like a Smith squat in there, particularly like my quads. You probably even see them through my leggings. Like my quads are well developed, like they are a stronger point of my physique. So it's kind of like, what do I actually really need to work on right now? And it's most certainly my back, my lats. That was like the feedback from my last competition as well, which I knew it would be. Obviously delts as well, because they've never really been particularly well developed. Not for the category I need anyway, and not for how big I need them to be competitive next time round. So yeah, working a lot on my back and delts, which is why I finish all my sessions with delts. And yeah, really happy that this has been moved to a full body session now, because I much prefer training upper body, and it just means I don't have three lowers a week now, which the thought of that, the sound of that, isn't nice to me. And now I no longer have to say lower one, two, three. It's just lower one, lower two, and then I've got a full body session in the middle of the week and two uppers. The final exercise of this session then, seated calf raises. So yeah, we had the single arm dumbbell row added in, then we have a superset for arms, which, like I said, I didn't film. And then Christian said to me, oh, you can just leave calves. He actually took them out of the plan. He said, don't, you know, you don't have to do calves. Same, my old coach said the same to me. Oh, in figure, you know, judges aren't looking at your calves. You know, we're looking at your quads, your hamstrings, everything else. And yeah, funny enough, the head judge feedback that I got, he literally like drew lines around where my calves should be because I have no calves. So based on that feedback, I'm not going to just sack off calves. So I'm keeping them in the plan. I said to my coach, nope, I'm not making that mistake again that I made in my last off season of just, my coach says I don't have to train calves, so therefore I don't train them. I am training my calves. It's really not that difficult to just do three sets. Obviously, you know, I've had a break from lower now. I've done three exercises, then I've gone on and done delts, back and arms, and then just coming back to do my calves at the end of the session for three sets is really not that difficult. I go for, I think it's like 15 to 20 reps for three sets. So, you know, a slightly higher rep range. So trying to get, you know, upwards really 20 reps. And it always feels pretty vile. I don't actually like training calves at all, but doesn't mean I don't do them.
Good morning, afternoon, evening, YouTube. It's almost like I'm starting another video. It feels like I am because it's now Monday the 19th, I want to say. Yes, Monday the 19th. So we're a few days in the future now, but it's been a busy few days. So had client meetup on the weekend in Birmingham, so that was epic. I mean, the actual meetup itself was at Ultimate Fitness Birmingham, which is right near the train station, so I just thought it would be a good accessible place for everyone to get to from like down south. I had someone coming from Plymouth, for example, had some girls coming from like up near Middlesbrough way in the northeast. So yeah, we had a span of people kind of coming and then meeting in the middle of the country, and it was great. It was a great gym to train at. I got myself down there on Friday actually to do a posing session with Hannah. So Hannah, she did a couple of posing sessions with my girls on the Saturday morning for the start of the meetup, get everyone, you know, feeling confident for the start of the day, posing well, presenting their physiques well. So we had a bikini class and then we had a figure class. And yeah, I wanted to have my own session with Hannah the day before and also just gauge the gym, get a vibe for it, be able to kind of, you know, send my clients a couple of videos or pictures and just kind of reassure them what the gym was like. And I was very reassured myself that it's huge. Some gyms just, they look so much better in real life than on Instagram, and Ultimate Fitness was definitely that. So yes, there's like about three floors, I think, or something, it feels like that anyway. You know, they've got so much good kit, like Cyvex hack. They've got loads of like old school leg equipment as well that I use. Like I use the lying hamstring curl, and then I use the Gym Leco leg press, which is actually brand new. And then that was fantastic. Literally still had glute doms yesterday. And then they've got this whole like downstairs area with all the cables and all the push equipment, pulls kind of like upstairs with the leg stuff. But yeah, it's a very well kitted out gym, very, very spacious. And they have a new posing room. So actually I did get a really good amount of footage with Hannah. So I thought I would let you guys have a little sneak peek at what we got up to. You can like watch through some of the tips that Hannah gave me and just, I suppose, how I'm looking.
Ready? Right, so that's it.
No hips.
We're going across. Beautiful. Better. Much better. Then with this, we're driving those shoulders forwards to me. That's it. So you're almost going to think about, right now, they're behind you. You're almost going to unwrap. Yeah. Good. Right. I know that's going to feel so fucking odd. And then up slightly. Good. Rotation of the knees. Squeeze the glutes. It'll help. Good. From here, try and keep the hands closer to you. So don't take them so far in front. Now from here, we're stepping back, but we're gonna press slightly down at the wrists to pull the shoulders up again. Squeeze through here. Now we're going around, but we're gonna bop, yeah? So it's like a hit and then into the side shot straight away. Now, with this side shot, we're going to think about straightening the legs for now, because we're going to lean slightly forwards and then lift the chest. Stick it out. Go on. Up, up, up. Yeah, not just the chin, but I want that face to the side. Good. Much better. That's it. To then lean a little bit more. Good. To then step to the back. And you're going to keep this lift. Good, good. Rotation of the knees. So remember here, we're actually going to take the toes a little wider, just because I want to see those quads. Good. Nice. Now, relax for me. Much nicer. Okay. Again, with this, I want you to almost think about leaning a little bit to that corner and then thinking about like driving those hips like to me. So like a boom. Yeah, good. Then from here, you can simply go step, step to open. Yeah, and again, that step, step, because it's so small, you've got the ability to just go boom, boom, right?
Just like that.
With the other side, what we spoke about was that slight lean forwards, then lift of the chest, and then keeping this arm actually closer to you.
Yeah.
So it's not necessarily like the back shot completely. You're almost going to scoop through with this arm. That's better. So you're keeping the arm closer here so that you're driving through. Think about driving that left arm through instead of keeping it like the back shot. Good. And you're going to try and think about that elbow facing the side instead. Check chin's the actual side. Good. Nice. Slightly straighten this arm. Good. Nice and relaxed. Wrists and fingers. Beautiful. Relaxed.
Good.
And then step through. Good. Good. So, relax. Lovely. So when it comes to obviously the difference, fantastic. Do you have any questions on that? Do you want to go through it again, or do you want to have a little look at the PCA? Yeah. Okay, fantastic.
So I hope you enjoyed a little bit of an insight into my posing lesson there, and obviously how brilliant Hannah is. Obviously I've been posing for a few years now, but there's always so much more tweaks that you can make, especially like obviously I've not actively done any proper posing or had posing lessons since I prepped last year, so I'm rusty, and it was nice to kind of refresh that. And then as you might have heard at the end there, we did also look at some PCA posing, just because, you know, I'm no longer rigidly set on two bros anymore. I feel like obviously I wouldn't say I was pushed into that, but that was certainly like made out to be like the only route I should really be going down, so I kind of followed along with it. But now, you know, I'm working with a new coach and he's very much open to whatever I want to do. And to be honest, I cannot imagine competing and never doing a routine again. I'd love to do a routine again. So whether that's PCA or something else, I'll certainly be looking to do more than just two bros going forward. So yeah, we did have a look at some PCA posing, which was also pretty fun. And then yeah, chilled in the evening. We stayed overnight in a hotel with my sister who came with me, because obviously I've been coaching her now for at least 5 years. And she did incredibly well as on her session on Saturday as well. She sumo deadlift PB'd 170 kilos, which is going to be in the next YouTube video. So the videographer caught loads of amazing footage. We all had an epic training session. The girls posed beforehand, like I said, bikini then figure. So I'll just show you a couple of clips of that now.
To bring here. Good. Lovely. Like up here and you're trying to get your boobs like all the way up, yeah? Good, really good, good. Remember, for you, it was making sure you're not leaning back.
Yes,
just a little bit. That's a lot better. So it's the lean forward, but the pull up. That's better, lovely. Can you see how much thickness you can get here? Good, relax.
Okay, I'm pretty sure that's everything for this vlog, to be honest. You've had a little bit of a taste of some of what went on at the team meet. Plenty more to come though. Super excited to drop the YouTube video when it's all been edited and put together by the amazing videographer. That's the second time I've used him now, because the last YouTube video he created for my team meet was really good. So I just asked him to come again. He gets on with the girls. He knows how to be a bit of a fly on the wall as well, so they don't feel like nervous that they're being filmed, especially like in the posing classes and stuff like that. So loads of sick footage to come. It'll give you a right good vibe of like how my team is. You know, there's lots of friendships being formed now, people coming back to the meets and meeting up again and things like that. So it's really good to see. It's really nice to just see people
you know, obviously they're like-minded, they're into their training, they obviously get on with myself, they've chosen me as a coach, so therefore they get on. And yeah, it's just nice to see bonds being formed. So it was a really successful day, obviously super stressful to organise. My stress levels last week were pretty high on the whole, like I don't usually get that stressed, but I was pretty anxious all week last week. And yeah, I got back from the team meet and I was like a couple of pounds down and I was like shocked, you know. I hit a low of like 142.6 yesterday. I'm back up to 144 this morning because that is just the luck of the draw, my friends. I tell this to my clients all the time, your weight will fluctuate. It'll be down, then it'll be back up. So yeah, we'll see. I would like it to go back down tomorrow, obviously. Tomorrow is check-in day, so we will see what comes. But tomorrow is check-in day where I will be finding out about my peak week protocol, which will start on Friday. So I'm pretty excited for that. I'll be a week out from the shoot on this coming Friday. So it's like basically 10 days out now, I want to say. 11 days out maybe. Yeah, so from Friday, food will be going up again, but essentially just peaking. So just adding more carbs in across the week. And yeah, I'm not sure what else will happen. I've never worked with my coach like this before. This is obviously the first diet we've done together. And he certainly hasn't peaked me for anything before. So we will see. I'm very intrigued to see what he's going to do. Obviously, I will keep you all informed. I will try and film as much of the peak week as I possibly can to get it across to you. You'll get to see a little bit of what goes down at the shoot as well. So it's going to be cool next couple of weeks, you know, getting this diet out of the way. Yeah, as of yesterday, I was basically like 13 pounds down. So we'll see what tomorrow brings. But yeah, I've done pretty well. I'd say I've done pretty well. You know, things have ended, 5 lots of 30 minutes cardio, 12k steps throughout. And then it's just been a case of bringing that food lower. So we did have a food drop off last week's check-in, obviously, and that brought me down to about 1600 on a training day and 1500 calories on a rest day. And that's that. So the rice cakes had to go, unfortunately. Now it's literally just a case of oats and potatoes on a training day. Now I'm talking like 130 grams of potatoes as well. And then on a rest day, it's literally just like 2 bowls of oats and then just like salads and yogurt throughout the day. So pretty boring, pretty simple, gets the job done. We've lost the weight. I'm feeling a lot better in my physique. And yeah, I wouldn't say ready to push up again from like a physique standpoint. You know, I could always be a bit leaner, but that's why there's another mini cut that's going to come. I'm going to do about 5 months of pushing back up now, and then there'll be another mini cut in sort of like August time, basically pull back again and just get back a little bit leaner. But I'm not planning on pushing up that hard this time. I don't want to gain a lot of the weight back, to be honest with you. I want to hold where I am, really. Yeah, and just kind of push food up, but like only in line with my body's response to that food, and not just, you know, pushing it up, because yeah, I don't need to like recover from this mini cut as such. It's not like I'm absolutely smashed or battered or anything, and just adding in food incrementally will obviously just see my training performance go up over the weeks, which is what I'm looking forward to. So yeah, no big heavy push up this time around. I don't want to do that. You want to keep things fairly tidy, and then just, yeah, do another pull back in August, September time, and that'll bring me back down even further. And then obviously we'll just have another little push up to come for like the rest of the year until prep starts in early 2025. So that's the plans at the moment. Super excited for it. And yeah, just stay tuned, because next week it will be peak week and it'll be the end of the mini cut and it'll be the photo shoot. And then obviously I will also drop another video, a much more professionally done video that my videographer has done. So can't wait to show you a little bit of my team and the vibes. And obviously, if you're watching this and you thought about joining my team, if you thought about coaching with myself, by all means, please get in touch. You know, the links for my Instagram is below, as well as like just the link to apply for coaching as well, which will take you straight through to my WhatsApp so we can get chatting. And yeah, all of the links below, you'll find anything you need from there. But yeah, if you've got any questions as well about this video in general, always grateful for your comments as well. If you want to leave any comments, just do that so below. And other than that, you know, there's got some good stuff coming. So yeah, make sure you are subscribed if you're not already. Make sure you liked this video if you got this far, like actually drop it a like. And yeah, thanks so much for watching. I will see you in the next one. Ciao for now.